'cause you took your time. And I waited. You say make up your mind. So I say I just keep on bumping. You took your time.
Hey everyone, this is Dan from the Rochester Indie Musician Spotlight and Three Heads Brewing. Today I'm sitting down with John Sheffer, the Rochester resident for the month of September, or as we'll call it from now on, Sheftember. He's playing three great Thursday concerts and a Friday show. We'll get into all of that. He's a great guitarist, flex the vocal chops for us too. John, thanks for your time, man. Appreciate it.
Thanks for having me.
All right, man, start off nice and easy. You a Rochester native?
Yes.
Okay, where in Rochester specifically?
I was born at Highland, mm-hmm. I believe. I grew up off of a corner of Norton and Culver, basically, and moved out to Webster for sixth grade and graduated from Webster High School, and I currently live in Irondequoit.
Cool, man. I live in Irondequoit, too. I don't know if I should say that because this is my house on camera, but whatever. Right. Talk to me about growing up. Like, did you come up from a musical family?
Yes. Mm-hmm. My dad plays guitar, and he always wanted to get me to play guitar when I was younger, but I ended up taking piano lessons mm-hmm. in elementary school, and then a little bit when we moved out to Webster, and mm-hmm. then I started playing guitar when I was like 15.
So what, you mentioned your dad was a guitar player, what kind of stuff did he like and was playing?
All the old school classic rock stuff, Hendrix, Pink Floyd, Deep Purple, Allman Brothers, Skynyrd.
Did that stuff influence you at all? Were you another direction guy, or did you go with what dad liked?
It's funny, because I didn't originally really appreciate it as much as I could have, but it was definitely a huge influence, yeah.
Right. When did you start writing songs? Because I feel like we've talked to so many people on the show, it always seems like, oh, 6 months ago, or like since I was six. Like, when did it start
That's funny.
For you?
All the writing of songs and parts that I do started probably, I'd say high school, end of high school. Mm-hmm. I was in a bunch of bands growing up after high school, and they're like heavier type of bands, like modern rock type stuff. And
right.
I used to write a lot with my buddy Mike and Adam and a bunch of guys.
Cool. Yeah. So like, was it like the more, so you said it was heavier, we were like more influenced by like the classic rock guys, or were you more into like what was happening then?
At that time, I would say I was more into what was happening then, or like early 90s.
Yeah.
Like grunge rock stuff, like Alice in Chains, STP, I was a big fan of that stuff.
Absolutely. So the other thing we like to ask on the show is, especially people who are from Rochester, when did you break into the music scene here? When did you feel like you were starting to like really get out and become a part of the community we have here?
It's tough to put it. I'm still trying. It's tough to put it.
Aren't we all, my friend? Yeah.
I would say when I started gigging out a lot with MoChester, I was probably like the first time I really felt like we could, you know, get a draw at places when we said we would, and we were playing so much. So I'd say probably around then, yeah.
Cool. And everyone knows you from MoChester. So for those who don't know, tell us about the band.
Yeah, MoChester is a four-piece rock reggae band. Mm-hmm. My brother, Brandon Sheffer, is the lead singer. We've got Alex Melville on drums and Ben Overmeyer on bass.
Mm-hmm.
And got three albums out and in the middle of working towards seven more tunes right now. And
I thought you were going to say seven more albums.
Seven more albums.
Wow, he's delivering this like in a very cool fashion for like seven more albums.
Just like seven more, yeah.
MoChester has been such a mainstay part of this scene. Everyone appreciates what you do. And you said like you finally can go out and draw the crowd you want. Man, how does that feel to be like a band that people like really love and appreciate?
Feels great.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's always a great time. And, you know, we've played a lot of places and not had that for a long time. And it's nice to come to your hometown and play a sweet show and have all your buddies show up, you know. And
It's a good feeling.
Yeah, I like it.
And speaking of playing a great show and having buddies show up, a lot of you who might not have known John or Chef, are you a John or a Chef guy? Did you respond to either?
I do, yeah.
Because I don't really respond to Gross anymore.
No.
Like, ever since I graduated high school and I was done playing football and people stopped calling me Gross because I played sports, like, I'm good. I'm Dan now. Anyway, so if a lot of you watching maybe didn't know John from his other projects, he has been in a ton of these residency shows here at Three Heads. What's that experience like, man? I have not made an official list, but you have to be up there.
It's up there.
Played with the most of them.
It is absolutely awesome. It's such a unique experience, and you get to play with a ton of musicians that you've always wanted to, or you know, you've looked up to for years, and you just never get to collaborate because everybody's always gigging at the same times, and just a great opportunity to get together with, you know, the Fleetwood Mac show was so awesome, and getting to work with Charlie and Matt and Katie and Tegan and Kyle, like, was just awesome.
Yeah.
And I did the Paul Simon one with Adrian. That was great. A whole other group of players I never would have gotten to play with otherwise. And the Huey Lewis was awesome. And
Huey Lewis show, almost forgot about that.
Wolfpack was really cool. That was a really fun one.
And yeah,
then
man.
We just did the Stevie Wonder one, which was killer too. And
it was. I think his fingers are still cooling off from now on, as everyone's are. He's been a busy man. He just came from the State Fair to do this interview with us.
I did.
So you were probably the most mentally prepared out of anyone to do these run of shows.
It's okay.
So let's go through them. As we mentioned, he's doing three Thursday shows and a Friday show. So we talked about MoChester. They're kicking it off September 5th. So they're the opening night. And then you're doing something I think is a pretty cool thing for opening acts. Why don't you tell us about these opening acts?
Would love to. So I've been working with the Camp ROC Star program, Valvio Fernandez, and all those awesome people over there for past, it's been 2 years now, almost three, that we've been doing the Academy, I think. Don't quote me on that. And then it started out as a summer camp, and I got into it about 4 years ago doing the summer camp, and it was super awesome. And then LVO decided to make it a year-round program. So we've got a great studio space in Webster, and there's two bands in particular that I've been coaching for a couple of years, and I'm going to have each of those bands open up for each of my original projects.
So for the first one, you have Phantom Opera, that's spelled with an F. Tell us about these kids.
It's Phantom with an F. They're my older of the two bands. Really, really great kids. This a six-piece band. We got a female singer. Her name's Danielle. And then this guy named Cole who sings. And Mike is on keyboards and backup vocals also. And then awesome lead guitar player Sammy. And bass player Kieran. And the drummer is Nathan. And they're just awesome. It's really super inspirational to work with them and, you know, watch them grow as a band. And
right.
Killer set list planned. It's going to be awesome.
It's going to be cool. We might all have to, like, squeegee our eyeballs. Like, wait, are these, like, kids? And they're, like, can't. Like, it's going
to
be.
I'm telling you, it's impressive. Like, I don't like to call them kid bands because I feel like it belittles, like, how really awesome they are. You know?
Yeah.
Like,
are they doing original music?
No, not currently. We started working on one song with those guys, but it's going to be a bunch of covers, but man, just.
That's the place to
done
start.
Done really
though.
Well. Yeah,
exactly. You know, like, that's. That's something that comes up with these residency shows from time to time. Like, the musicians love having this opportunity because when else can you set, like, put together an all-star cast?
Totally.
And, like, really get immersed in this amazing music because it makes your original music better, too.
It does. Every tribute I've done, it definitely, like, opens your mind up to, you know, thinking outside of the box and and not maybe doing the moves you're used to doing. And
right. Gets you to stretch the figurative... No, that's not what I want to say. The actual and proverbial fingers of your mind. Woo, nailed that one. Okay, you were very kind to donate one of your Thursday shows to Kyle Vock. We'll talk more about his residency. Needless to say, that's going to be a giant show if you don't already know what it is.
If you don't already know, you should know.
You should. Yeah. I like how he looks right in the camera for that one. So your show on Friday the 13th.
Friday the 13th, yep. We're not superstitious. We're diving right into it. And it's going to be a No Doubt tribute. We're going to play the Tragic Kingdom album front to back, and got an awesome all-star cast for that one. I've got Allison Stevens and Taylor Smith from Dial Up. Ben Overmeyer will be playing bass. Jimmy Grillo will be on drums. And Katie Wright just agreed to do some backup vocals.
Also. Nice. I hope this isn't the first time she's heard of it in this video.
She's heard of it a couple times.
Okay, before, yeah. That's good. What inspired you to do this project?
So when I was talking about my residency shows and making plans back in December, I was talking with my wife Amy about it a bunch, and she mentioned the album, and I was like, oh my God, like I remember growing up, and that was one of the first like CDs that I bought with my own money and like brought home and just opened it up and read along to all the lyrics and really like got into it and loved how different his guitar style was. And so originally I was planning on her singing it, and that was like what we decided, and now she's 9 months pregnant, so that was out the window when we found that out. And
yeah,
Allison,
man.
We were fortunate enough to know Allison, and she crushes Gwen Stefani's vocals, so it's gonna be killer. I'm really excited.
It is gonna be killer. 9 months pregnant.
Ooh. You know what? I almost forgot. Glad I just remembered. We also will have a horn section too.
Very exciting. Yeah. Who's in that?
So that is gonna be Dan Murky, and I'm gonna space on the trombone player's name right now. I'm sorry.
No, we'll get it in post. Don't sweat it.
We'll put it in the post.
I'm a trombone player. You and I, my friend, we can appreciate the humor in being left out on that. Okay, back to the Thursday shows. The 19th, Benjamin Sheridan and the Finer Things. Tell us about that project.
Correct. Benjamin Sheridan and the Finer Things is something that we started the full band with in January. Originally, so we know Ben Sheridan because he fills in for the singer of Big Eyed Phish occasionally. And he's opened for the band a bunch, and Jimmy and I really dug his originals, and he asked us to join as a trio to open for TR3 back in late December, early January, I want to say. And we did the show, and it just felt great, and he needed a bass player, so I decided I was going to play bass. Ooh. So we did bass, drums, and acoustic, and after the show went really well, and we had a really fun time, so we added Tim Cash on guitar, and Dan Murky was on saxophone for a brief moment. But yeah, it's very different from everything I've ever done musically. Like, I've always wanted to play bass, but always wanted to have my own bass rig and like write bass lines and stuff. So it's fun. It's a good time.
All right, A Man After My Own Heart, and the band opening up for you guys is another Camp ROC Star band, Channel 38.
My other Camp ROC Star band, and these are, I would dare to say, probably the youngest kids, and you would not know it. They do such a great job, and they're super into classic rock like I was growing up, and their set list is just, I'm always blown away because people think that it's me telling them what songs to play, but legit, every single one of these songs that they're going to play are inspired by them, and they bring them up at rehearsal, and they're good. It's very classic rock, though, and it's cool.
Awesome. Love it. And the final one, Incubus, 20th anniversary of the Make Yourself album. What drew you to this, man?
Incubus is one of those bands that really shaped the style of playing that I had for a long time and that I was really into. I loved them. I like the older stuff, Make Yourself, Fungus Among Us, older stuff, Science. and we put a tribute together 2 years ago and played 3 or 4 shows and had a really good time. We tributed the album Science and we did that, and you know, the heavier stuff. It was a ton of fun, and I've been looking for a reason to bring it back, and the anniversary of Make Yourself and a Three Heads Residency was a great idea, I thought.
Yeah, it's a good pairing, as we like good to pairing, say, in yes. the brewery business. All right, everyone, we got through all the weeks. Let's run them down. On Thursday the 5th, we have MoChester with a little help from Phantom Opera, one of his Camp ROC Star bands. That's Phantom with an F, by the way. I've been told I have to reiterate that. Then we're going on to Friday the 13th, not a spooky night, but No Doubt is playing. And then back to Thursday show on the 19th, Benjamin Sheridan, The Finer Things, openers Channel 38. And then September 26th, we have the 20th anniversary of Make Yourself by Incubus. One more time, I'm Dan Gross. That's Jonathan Sheffer, the Rochester resident for Sheftember at Three Heads Brewing. We hope to see you those three Thursday and that one Friday at Three Heads Brewing.
Rip it.
Rip it or rip it, baby.
Johnny Water just to save us. Been a minute too deep and I don't want you to say the things that I want to hear. Let me be clear, this is far from over, but the last time
23 on the verge, spontaneous combustion, woe is me. But I guess that it comes with the territory, anomalous landscape of never-ending calamity. I need you to hear, I need you to see that I have had all I can take, and exploding seems like an evident possibility to me. So barring me while I burn, the world in its people's mindless game. So pardon me while I burn and rise above the flame. Pardon me, pardon me, won't ever be the same. Well, 2 days ago I was having a look in a book, and I saw a picture of a guy fried up above his knees. Said I can relate, cause lately I've been thinking of combustion as a welcome vacation from burdens of flattened earth, the gravity, hypocrisy, and the perils in being in 3D. thinking so much differently. Pardon me while I burst into flames. I've had enough of the world in these people's mindless game. Pardon me while I burn to rise above the flames. Pardon me, pardon me. Won't ever be the same. Never be the same again. Pardon me while I burst into flames. Pardon